Hey everybody, this is Dr. Glenn, and I am so sorry. I didn't go live, even though I thought I was live. So I've already done the presentation, but nobody got to see it because I didn't click the right button. And so what we're going to do is we're going to do it again. So today what we're going to do is talk about, hold on a second. Let me get out of here. Just click the wrong button. Technology is a wonderful thing unless you mess it up. All right, so let's do this again. Today we're going to talk about GABA, gamma-aminobutyric acid. GABA is the neurotransmitter that helps you feel calm and keeps you from being panicky and anxious and anxiety and things like that. So let's do some of the signs that you will see if a person is having a problem with GABA. Feelings of anxiety or panic, difficulty shutting the mind off, feelings of being overwhelmed for no reason, disorganized attention, feelings of restlessness, you cannot initiate projects. Now, this is different than dopamine. Remember, dopamine was a problem for people if you couldn't finish a project once you started it. You know, you'd get a bunch of things going and you weren't finishing anything. Well, GABA is the one that gives you trouble actually getting something done or getting it started. You know you need to go out and do something. There's a project or something that you need to do, but you can't start it. That is a GABA issue. Also, feelings of restlessness, disorganized attention. Oh, I read those. People who startle easily. Their nervous system is so close to threshold that the slightest little thing causes them to have a bam, just a huge exaggerated response. People who have difficulty calming down have GABA problems. You know, we all get upset. We all get upset every now and then, and it is normal. It happens. But if you get upset, but you have trouble calming yourself back down, that is a GABA issue. Severely sensitive to light and sound. You know, some people are so sensitive to light and sound. That's a GABA problem. Also, if you have an increased resting heart rate, that is very often an indication of a GABA problem. So let's pull that down. Xanax, that's the big drug that you normally hear of that goes along with GABA because it helps to suppress your nervous system. People with GABA issues, I mean, don't want to cover those up like that. A lot of people with GABA issues are also gluten intolerant. And I'm going to get into that in just a minute. But gluten intolerance, things that go along with celiac disease, Hashimoto's disease, and various autoimmune diseases that that are driven by gluten sensitivities and gluten intolerance can also give you GABA problems. As a matter of fact, let me go right here. GABA deficient people, they're the ones that like to fall asleep with the TV on. You know, I was talking about the people that have difficulty in staying focused. So if you're the kind of person where, you know, you're watching TV, you're texting, you're reading a magazine, you're doing all these things at the same time, this is very, very indicative of a GABA problem. Here, let me show my overlays. Okay, great. All right, now let's go on down here and so what are the things that GABA does? Well, GABA relieves anxiety, it improves sleep, it reduces depression symptoms, it relieves the symptoms of PMS, it also decreases inflammation. It improves focus, especially in ADHD, you know, your hyperactivity disorder people. And it also improves focus and, also in kids with autism spectrum disorders. And it increases the level of growth hormone. One of the things that you'll see in kids with autism spectrum issues is often a stunted growth pattern. They just are not growing like they should. And hi, Cindy, thanks. So you'll see that. I've written something down here. Let me find it because I don't want to get this wrong. But gluten intolerance, celiac disease, and autoimmune diseases, they can trigger an autoimmune reaction to the enzyme that's responsible for making GABA. Now, here's where GABA tends to come from. There's a few sources, but you have foods that are high in something called glutamic acid, okay, or glutamate. And when you eat those foods, and there are things like eggs, cheese, some nuts, soy, a lot of things have glutamate or glutamine in them. And what your body should do with those is take them and convert the glutamate, the glutamic acid, into GABA. Now remember, this is sort of a two-edged sword thing right here, because glutamate is an excitatory substance. It makes your nervous system excitable, but you convert that into GABA, which calms your nervous system down. Now, if you develop a problem in that transition, then when you eat certain foods, you actually get ramped up. A great example of this is monosodium glutamate. When you eat monosodium glutamate, if it gives you that hyperactive feeling, if it gives you that headache problem and so forth, one of the things that shows you, one, you're sensitive to it and you should stay away from it. Also, you probably are having a problem converting the glutamate into GABA. This is a really common situation in kids with autism spectrum disorder. This is one of the reasons why they can tend to be so hyperactive or hyper excitable and super sensitive to sensory input, is because they don't have the right GABA levels calming down that nervous system. And there are things that can be done to improve this. One of them is you've got to get a good healed, healthy gut going on. So I wanted to mention that right there. Let's go through and let's look at a few other things. Let's talk about some things that you can do. Here are some nutritional compounds that are really great for people with GABA issues. Valerian root is one. Valerian root does very similar functions to melatonin. And you know, melatonin is the substance that helps you fall asleep, okay? So valerian root can also do that. Now, I'm going to suggest that you don't mix them, because you can get the dosages wrong and you can end up with a bad reaction. But valerian root will also help to calm you down, and it supports GABA activity, which so that's really great. Lithium orotate, that is not the lithium that's used for bipolar. It's a different form of lithium that helps support GABA activity. Passion flower extract is a great thing for that. And the next two things, L-theanine and taurine, those are both amino acids, and they are part of the neurotransmitter production line, and they also participate in the production of serotonin and dopamine. So that's how these things tend to go together. P5P, magnesium, zinc, and manganese are all things that you can get over the counter. And you know, a lot of this stuff is in good multivitamins. If you have an amino acid deficit, then you might want to be taking some amino acids as well. We have some really good products for this. I'm not trying to necessarily sell you a product, but we have a couple of things, one called Gabatone, one called GabaCore. We even have a little spray that you can carry with you. You carry it in your purse or something. And when you feel anxious, just a couple squirts, a couple sprays in the mouth, and bam, it just calms things right down. So that's really good. If that interests you, you can give the office a call and you can check that stuff out. Let's talk about some things that you can do to improve your GABA levels. One is adapt to stress better. Now, that's one of those things that's easier said than done. You know, but a lot of times, if you have a little trigger that can help you to calm down, you see I see this in like professional golfers. You'll see sometimes they'll be wearing like a little rubber band around their wrist. And when they get themselves stressed out, they'll pop that rubber band, and it just kind of helps them calm down, focus, get your mind back in the game. By the way, speaking of golf, I have to do a shout out for my son. He lives in England. He played a 36-hole tournament on Sunday, shot 11 under par for 36 holes, set a new course record, won the championship. Way to go, James. All right, some other things. Anti-inflammatory diet. You know, the more we understand about these problems, the more important diet becomes. And when I say anti-inflammatory, I'm going to go kind of in two parallel paths right here. Carbohydrates, that's a long word for sugar. So just think carbohydrate equals sugar. Carbohydrates and sugars are inflammatory. The number one source of carbohydrate that we eat in a Western diet is grain. And we've been told since the 1970s that we should eat large amounts of heart-healthy whole grains. Well, grains are carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are inflammatory. Heart disease is an inflammatory disease. It is not a lipid disease. It is an inflammatory disease. So we've been eating exactly the wrong diet for the last 40 years. Cut the inflammation out. Cut the grains out. Cut the sugars out. You're going to feel a lot better when you do. You also want to make sure that you're sleeping well. You know, your bedroom is not just another room in the house to watch television in. As a matter of fact, I haven't allowed a TV in the bedroom for probably 30 years. Get rid of the TV. You don't want to be distracted like that. You don't even want those electromagnetic waves in the bedroom when you're trying to sleep. Other things you need to do is improve your microbiome. One of the things you do is get rid of the inflammatory foods. It's not good for your gut, but also, you know, good quality probiotics and a great diversity. That's good for your microbiome that helps you to make all of this stuff. Taking Epsom salt baths with essential oils. Now, how's that? Epsom salt, there's a name from the past, but get in the bathtub, calm down. Just let yourself chill out. Well, you don't want it too chilly, but just let yourself relax. Do some deep breathing while you're in there and get yourself a really, really nice, relaxed time. The other thing that's really good for GABA production is regular exercise. So those are just some tips, some things that you can do to raise your GABA levels. Those things will also help your serotonin and dopamine production as well. Now, what I want to throw out here is somebody wrote into us last week and asked if I would do a segment on adrenal fatigue. And so next week, we are going to talk about the adrenal glands, what they do, adrenal fatigue, and so on and so forth. And that's what our next subject will be there. If you want to ask me a question, type it in. It'll pop up on my screen and I can see it. I got a couple of minutes here. I'm happy to answer any questions. Also, if you would like to recommend a topic for a future Dr. Glenn Live, I am happy to accommodate that, provided it's something that I know something about, or I'll study for it. That'd be good. I can learn something myself. But somebody wrote in last week and asked if we would do one on adrenal fatigue, and so we're going to do that. Also, this weekend, just a few days ago, I was at a conference on aging brain and brain degeneration, and I learned an awful lot of really cool stuff there, and we're going to be bringing that in over the next few weeks as well, because you know what we found out, you see these commercials on television now for autism support and autism research, you know, and they're talking about the first autism survivor. Well, there are already people surviving autism because they use functional medicine. When you make the lifestyle and nutrition changes that are required to lower the inflammation levels in the brain, you can take autism, cognitive decline, and dementia if you catch it early enough and reverse it. So we're doing the Bredesen protocol here in the clinic, and we are seeing people reverse their cognitive decline scores. It's really, really cool. And that's a big deal because, you know, hopefully we're all getting older. I don't want you to die before you get older. I want you to get nice and old and have a sharp, sharp mind when you get there. And everything else working as well, too. So if you'd like to ask me some questions, or if you would like to recommend a topic for request a topic, just write to me at Dr. Glenn Live, DrGlennLive, live at gmail.com. Just send me an email, and if you've got some requests or something like that, or if you'd like to ask a question and you don't want to put it out, you know, on the air like this, that's just fine. I'll be happy to answer your questions. I check that email address every day. And if you write to me, I'll be happy, happy to respond. So thanks so much for being here today. GABA helps you calm down. Oh, by the way, if I didn't say this before, you know, when you wake up in the middle of the night and your mind is racing, it's because your GABA levels are naturally low at night. They're low because you shouldn't need it at night because you're supposed to be asleep. That's the origin of the saying, everything looks better in the morning, because your GABA levels come back up in the morning. And so, yes, everything does look better because your nervous system is calm in the morning. So this is Dr. Glenn. Thanks so much for being here today. I hope you have a great day, and I will see you next week.